folks, it's Brian here, and it's time to work on my junky truck. So this is my F-350 rescue project. I bought this thing in a field, and what I'm working on today is the glowplug controller down here. I relocated it off the back of the engine, and then I made a new glowplug harness. You can see videos about that. I keep the batteries on life support right now. It just is what it is. Let me get this set up. Right now, the glow plugs aren't getting power when I turn the key to on, and so I'm gonna test that. I think it's a bad solenoid, and I've got the solenoid, so if it's solenoid, I'm just gonna change it. But let's go through the troubleshooting process. All right, so first things first, you're gonna need a multimeter. It doesn't have to be anything magical. This is just some cheap multimeter off of Amazon. Verify we've got voltage. So I'm just gonna put the negative probe into the negative battery terminal. I'm gonna see if I can find a place to wedge this. All right, I gotta get a clip for it, hang on. So it's just easier for me with multimeter leads if I clip them in place so that I don't have so many things to focus on. It just tends to be less frustrating. So now I've got one lead to test. Still got 14 volts. I'm gonna get another test lead here. The reason I'm using clip leads is I want to see what's happening at different points in the process. So, first things first, why do I have 30 millivolts? Okay, so I've got 30 millivolts leaking through the ignition. Still 23 millivolts. So, what I want to do is turn the key on and see what's going on. Should get 14 volts at this point. I got 12 volts. That's close enough. 12.4. What do I got over here? 13.4 the battery. That's interesting. And then what do I got down here? 12.4. So I got 13 and 0. So I have a relay that's not relaying. And now, it's possible that it's the it's got a bad ground, so let's short that out. Let's check this, let's see. Nope, it should have closed when I touch this lead from, so this is 12 volts, this is the coil on the solenoid. When I ground out the coil, it should close. So it's not closing, that means we got a bad coil. So let me go get that part and we'll get that changed. So I'm gonna show you that this, I'm just gonna prove out my theory on the coil. So that's my hot. Okay, so we can test it here. Oh, actually, the coil works. So that means we're not getting control signal. All right, well, that's a good reason to test it. But it doesn't consistently want to run. So I still think we have a bad coil. So I'm gonna change the coil because I really do think it's bad. All right, so first things first, we've got to disconnect batteries. So we should disconnect the battery. I don't feel like screwing with that, so I'm going to do this the fun and exciting way. So I've got a hot lead from battery here, and then I've got... So if I take this off, that should disconnect all my batteries. And then I've got some shade and void going on over here. This is just not quite long enough. I really should fix that too. Maybe I'll fix that while I'm in here. Maybe not. All right, let me go see if I can find the wrenches and get this started. So I'm going to take this jumper cable from the battery that powers the whole truck. I'm going to remove this. So that's a hot wire for the battery, and the best thing to do with this is tuck this back under the battery where it is out of harm's way. Now, there's different ways to do this, and some people will be critical of that. It is what it is. All right, so now I'm going to verify my... Verify that I've disconnected the power. Zero, 14, zero, zero, zero. Okay. That's what we want to see. Let me go turn the keys off. Okay, so these are our fusible links coming in from the battery. That's our white control wire, which grounds out. And then we have a sensing wire. See what it's going to take to get this off. Alright, I gotta go find a 7/16, I'll be right back. Alright, so we got this. Now we can't get into it. Things that are going to happen here, it's either going to work or it's going to get shorted out and replaced and become a manual glow plug. One of those two things is going to happen. Because, you know, I live in Houston and we don't really need glow plugs here. They just shorten the starting time. Get that secured. go ahead and just connect our voltage source. Now, this came with some new hardware, so I'm going to install the new hardware. Picture on my phone and see exactly where those were. Okay, so I have that right. So the reason this has two nuts on it is one is for the computer and it stays permanently attached. These old track scissors, no crevices that don't lead to the bottom of the truck. That's probably the wrong one. then the other one comes from the ignition to let the computer know that it should fire up. Alright, and then we got one for the white wire for the sensing, or for the ground. The computer controls the ground with this. So what should happen now is that I should be able to power this back up and it should just work. I suspect that's not going to be the case, but we'll see. See what's going on here. I have that hot wired. Yeah, that's going to need to be changed eventually. So this is the run solenoid, and it should have been engaged, but it wasn't. So it really wasn't doing anything. Alright. So this is just an extension of the ignition. Alright, let me set up for testing. Voltage, no voltage. No voltage. All right, I'm gonna go turn the key on. No voltage. the starter solenoid, and I don't have the starter run up to here, so I probably should fix that. Don't see a large wire running down to the starter though. I didn't break that. That didn't feel like it was supposed to move. All right, let's see what's going on. I don't hear that clicking. So let's see where we've got voltage. Thirteen volts, no volts. So the computer's trying to turn it on. Now it looks like it's a grounding issue. Let's see. Yeah, no voltage up there. Mm-hmm. I need to figure out where the way to start wire is. So that's the only thing that's not hooked up right now. I've got this wire here. Alright, I'm going to pause this while I figure out. So I think this black and pink wire is actually my missing wait to start light. And if that's the case, the computer is really not getting the right, it's a wiring issue. So I'm going to, actually I'm going to cut this off. Let me find a pair of clippers. It's been 2 months since I've worked on this, so it's taken me some time to find everything. I really think this should have been. Alright, yeah, it'll work. Alright, I really would have expected it to not want to work with these. Alright, now where did our black and pink go? Water and fuel, water and fuel, water and fuel. Oh, let's just move all these over. A little bit of heat shrink work to do here. So, if that's the problem, then this jumper will fix it. So let's see. That's not a good sign. I'm honestly getting really irritated at this. I don't have any voltage there. Or here. Alright, so I'm not really on. Alright, let's solve that problem first. There. So why don't I have voltage at the keys? What did I screw up? Starter, so I shouldn't have it there. Alright, let me go play with. The voltage there. Not there. Give it voltage. All right, we're just going to give it voltage. That validates the glow plug controller. So I'm going to wait for it to cycle. It should start cycling. Alright, so that's ready to start. Maybe I don't see smoke. Maybe I just imagine any shit. So the question is, what in the fuck is going on with my... Alright, let's go ahead and fix the starter wire while we're at it, because I'm tired of having a jumper in here. Right back. All right, so I've solved the wait to start light issue. So, ouch, damn it, that's hot. Not a good way either. So the white wire is a ground to open the relay, and the black and pink wire goes to the dash. When you ground it, the wait to start light comes on, and it stays on as long as that's grounded. So what it looks like right now is if I attach this wait to start light to the white wire, the controller turns it on and off. What I can't figure out is why the controller isn't working automatically. And so I think what's going to end up happening is I'm going to get a switch in the dash, and I'm just going to push the button when I want the glow plug controller on. And that's going to be the end of that. And then the computer still does its job. It still measures the resistance on the glow plugs. And it does start way easier than it used to. So I'm going to consider that a win. That's not the right one. That explains why it's being janky. That sure as hell isn't the right one. So I still need to, I want to extend the starter wire here. I wonder what that is. I bet that is why these don't work. I bet that's for the alternator. The alternator is a whole nother fucked up ass project. And that's not right now what we're working on. So let me get the starter wire extended. Guys can see this, because this is a little bit hard for me to get into. So just strip that little connection, and I'm gonna crimp on some more wire. Gotta go get another. That's not gonna work. shrink it. Allergies are absolutely killing me this week. All right. Where did my other piece go? Where the fuck did it go? Oh, what the fuck did I do with it? Alright, so I cut the other wire and I crimped a connector onto it. Oh, there it is. So figure out where I wanted that. Alright, that's where I want that. Heat shrink action. This back together. That's not acceptable. Let me go get something. So one of the challenges is just access sucks to this because it's so high up. next test we're going to do is a jumper from run to the solenoid. And let's just see if this fixes the solenoid behavior problem. That should be our ignition switch. So let's test that. May not need it. Let's just see if it starts then. Possible that this caused an issue. Thank you. the computer's not behaving. I mean, it's just not. Possible there's a ground issue. But I don't think that's it. I wish I had a more readily accessible ground tap. Grounded it there. Okay, that is a pretty accessible spot. So I'm going to rule out that it's not a ground issue. So I'm going to jumper the ground. That's jumpering the ground. I'm still not getting anywhere. So I think we're headed for a button. Because this is irritating. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Let me see where the key is. So that's key on. I should have fired up. And that's voltage in. So if I jumper around the computer, this is what a button would do. So then it starts right up. Yeah, so I don't know what's going on with the computer. So I can either spend $100 on the computer to replace it and see if I can make it work the way it's supposed to, or I could jumper it. Yeah, I gotta think about that. I suspect that's what this is.